What good is it when a man has his own CNC if he doesn't make himself a sign for his workshop first and foremost? Hey everybody, my name is Sam and welcome back to Samcraft. That's right, in today's video, I make my first sign on the CNC. Hey, that looks kind of familiar. First step in this project is to go ahead and cut my piece of wood to dimension. I'm going to cut myself a 12 by 12 piece of half inch thick Baltic birch plywood. I got a set of digital calipers here, and I'm going to use these to measure the precise thickness of my material. I'm not just going to take for granted that this is labeled or sold as half inch, it's actually half inch thick. In fact, it being Baltic birch, I know it's not half an inch because these are done in metric size increments. So I'm thinking 13 millimeter, but let's check that to make sure. All right, as you see there, this is 13 millimeters thick. So that's going to be the thickness of my stock that I plug into Carbide Create. Now it's time to go over there, load up my stock as my base for my model, bring in my logo, do a little bit of design, and basically form a pocket and then form a cutout for it. So let's go over to the computer. I don't know how well this is going to show, but here is my maker's mark or my brand in the computer, and it's showing all my tool paths. I basically have a pocket cutout around the S and the C, and then I've got a full cutout around the perimeter to give myself kind of a rounded curve on the square. These little dots are tabs that I'm going to leave in place to hold the piece since these are total cut-throughs. Let me go ahead and change to the 3D simulation. Here you can kind of get a better sense of what I'm going to have with the end product. We've got my piece of plywood here. The actual S and the C are going to be raised or normal height, and I'm going to pocket out the rest of it just a little bit to give a difference, and then this is going to be a total cutout as well. So with this done, I can go down and click on save G-code and save it to the file where I want, and then load it up in Carbide Motion. All right, it's gone through its homing sequence. The next thing is prompting me in Carbide Motion. Since I have the bit setter enabled, it's up here, it's going to want to go ahead and tell me to load the tool, which is already in there. It's a quarter inch end mill. It's going to bring it over, set the bit, and take it back to where it's at now. All right, with that done, now I can use my little wireless keyboard and I'm gonna jog it back a little way so I have room to work. This is just a $13 USB wireless keyboard, but it makes it nice to control the machine. When my computer's over there, I can have this here in my hand. All right, that's good enough. For securing this plywood to the surface, I'm going to be using some blue painter's tape and some Starbond medium thick CA glue. I have the pretty side of my piece up, so I want to go ahead and flip it over and lay down some tape on the wood, and then lay down tape on my table, and then glue them together with the CA glue. I'm going to roughly space this piece back from the front of my wasteboard, just to get it square with the front. Since this is a full cutout and I'm not keeping the actual outside perimeters of this piece, I'm not going to obsess about making sure it's perfectly square because my final piece will be correct according to my file, how I created it. All right, now let's see how carefully Sam can flip this piece over. Might end up just being a wonderful disaster here. So pretty good there, pretty good here. There we go. Let's clean this thing off and let's get ready to run this file. All right, I'm at the point where I'm ready to go ahead and set the zero on my machine. The Serpoco Pro comes with a Sweepy 2.0 attachment, and it's got a magnetic connection for the bottom part with the brushes, which is really handy because I'm using the Carbide 3D Bit Zero. I'm gonna sit it here on the corner of my workpiece. I'm gonna clip the alligator clip on the actual bit itself. Make sure I have good connection. And now put it back on because it falls off. There we go. And now I'm going to go ahead and tell the machine to go ahead and zero all three axes. But I need to put it kind of close to the dot. So let me do that first. All right, looks pretty close. Now I'm going to run the automatic zeroing process in Carbide Motion for the corner, X, Y, and Z axes. We are ready to start the job. For this one, I'm going to use the Sweepy attachment that has no brushes so that the camera still can see as much as it can, but I can still use my dust collector as well. Well, guys, the job just finished. I am really excited. It worked. I didn't crash a bit and everything's off, so I can go ahead and say that now for my first job. Major success. Now it's time to go ahead and pull this thing up off the table and see how well it did as far as did I get correct on my zero? Is the bit zero correct? You know, I measured the thickness of the plywood with calipers, 13 millimeter thickness. So I punched in the machine. Did I carve an outline in my wasteboard, or are we totally good? Let's check. It's also a good test of how strong are tabs. I have 8 tabs total, 2, 4, 6, and 8. And also how strong is the blue tape and CA glue. So this is a really good sign. I did not cut through my tape where the pockets or cutout was done. So that is awesome. And my waste board or my bed is unscathed. Man, I lucked out. Let's take this over and go ahead and cut out these little tabs, clean off the bottom, and kind of get a better picture of what we're working with. There we go. We have one cutout Samcraft logo. Need to do a little touch-up hand sanding in here. So let me do that real quick and be back in a second. Ta-da! Pretty cool. Now, I know I could probably go ahead and paint this and do some other cool things with that, but I want to leave it natural for now. This kind of sign, I can definitely understand why people do like epoxy pours and things, because that would be perfect for making this pocket and the accent piece pop. But I don't have any epoxy. So what I'll probably will do is paint it, possibly. Although I really like the look of the natural wood as well. And it's kind of cool. It's my first thing I've ever made on my CNC. And it's my logo. It's like a little sign. Or a little plate. I gotta make it a little plate. Either way, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I definitely enjoyed getting my toes wet with the CNC. This was a very easy project to do as far as design. And as far as making, I just used one tool, a 1/4 inch end mill. And that's pretty much it. I appreciate you guys watching as always. If you're not a subscriber and you're interested in this kind of content, or you kind of like my personality and antics, I'd love to have you join me here on Samcraft. Otherwise, take care guys, and I'll see you next time in the workshop.